Hey guys, if you're new or returning, welcome to the channel. Today I want to show you how I made this custom two-tone hoodie. So I'm going to speed up the video while I speak. I already went ahead and cut both hoodies horizontally in half, but you can cut your hoodie vertically, diagonally, in different patterns. It's totally up to you. This one the customer requested that she wanted it horizontally, so that's why it's cut horizontally. So I'm lining them up right now, but I am going to clip or snip all four corners so I can line it back up perfectly. All right, so I'm flipping it back on the right side so I could line it up properly. So I'm just getting my scissors real quick. And now I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna snip. Just a small snip. Don't take off too much of the fabric, just a small snip. You just want to know where your corners are so you can line them back up perfectly. Now flip it inside out on the wrong side and pin them back together. You can use straight pins, you can use wonder clips, just clip it back together, because after this we're just gonna do a straight stitch. So this is the first hoodie, and we're gonna go ahead and do the exact same thing on the second hoodie. Or I should say with the second hoodie. Again, snip your corners, then line them up. And once you're clipping it, make sure your shirt is turned inside out so that you're stitching everything on the inside or on the wrong side. Now we're going to go to the sewing machine, and it's just a straight stitch like I said to connect both parts. I am using my industrial machine, but if you don't have an industrial machine, that's no problem. Once you have a machine that can sew a straight stitch, you're fine. And once again, we're going to do the exact same thing on the second hoodie. After this, we're going to go ahead to the serger and we're going to serge the inside just to make our hoodies look neat and tidy. Now on my serger, I have black thread, but you can use any color thread that you so desire. I just wanted mine to blend in to the black and red, so I'm using black thread. And we're gonna do the same thing on the second hoodie also, right? Next, we go to the embroidery machine, because now we are going to add this applique design to the top of the hoodie. My customer wanted a delta design, so what I did, I took a regular font and I went ahead and turned it into an applique font. I redigitized it or digitized it into an applique font. So that was the placement stitch, and I'm using glitter flake vinyl. So this is the red glitter flake vinyl that I'm doing a placement stitch on. And this is the fun part of it, right? We already did the hoodie. We made a custom hoodie. Now we're gonna personalize it even more for this customer. So if you're new to appliquing, this is a tack down stitch. The first one was the placement stitch, just show you where to place your fabric or your material. And this one is tacking down the material. Now I'm gonna go ahead and remove the excess vinyl. Just be gentle with it and remove all your excess vinyl. This case I'm using vinyl, but with applique, again, you can use whatever material or fabric that you so desire. She wanted glitter, so that's why I'm using my glitter vinyl. So remove all the excess vinyl. And then we're going to go back to the embroidery machine and do our satin stitch around, or our outline stitch. That's the correct word. It's an outline stitch, but it's a satin stitch. But before I do that, I quickly put some heat on my vinyl to help it adhere to my, well, to my shirt in this case. And then we'll go back to the embroidery machine. So here we go, we're doing the outline stitch, and this is the final phase of our customization. So here we are, the final product. This is a quick and easy project for you to create a custom one-of-a-kind item for your customer. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always guys, see you on the next one.